As we proceed to discuss and tackle the agenda for the proposed autonomy, we continue to bear in mind the pressing needs of development in all of our rural areas. The devolution of powers and functions from the national government to the autonomous region must take all this into account. For autonomy must address the full spectrum of the political, social, and economic aspirations of the constituent communities. In these communities, the people's basic concerns will remain potable water, health facilities, schools, livelihoods opportunities. As I said before when I signed the law providing for the Organic Act for Mindanao, autonomy must translate into the more effective delivery of these services. The national land agencies and the future autonomous government have a shared responsibility for moderating the disruptions inevitably resulting from change. We must now let people in a proposed autonomous region decide for themselves in a plebiscite whether the law meets their objectives. As before, I have directed the relevant government agencies to mount a massive information campaign to help the voters understand the basis of the autonomy law, its content and its implications, so as to give them a better foundation for making a rational decision. For the people must understand not only the benefits that autonomy will bring, but also the new responsibilities that they must bear.
Signing of the peace agreement to resolve the political issue in a principled manner through peaceful means, I would say that at least I could say truly that when we made a political decision to really push forward the liberation of the Cordillera people, never did I believe that in my lifetime we could attain such kind of political atmosphere. No, I thought at that time we would just show a small light for the future generation to follow. Because at that time we were so dispersed, parang impossible na now we could really consolidate our tradition and make it a homegrown political move to establish our nationhood. It is tremendous yung na-achieve for us who started the movement. But for those who came during the negotiation, it is also true na we underestimated yung capability natin. And so it is the fault of government that to take advantage of our incorrect reading of our capability, because it is the task of government to really fast track the development of people. Any government that cannot serve its people, it has no business existing.
The Cordillera People's Liberation Army, together with the Modern Bodong, the CBA, that was founded in 1982. This became a reality due to our historic Mount Data Sipat, or peace agreement in September 13, 1986. Meeting with then President Cory, we signed that document. No more discrimination. No more national oppression. No more minorities. We are all indigenous peoples. By virtue of this Mount Data Peace Agreement, we are now gathered here today to celebrate the 10th anniversary of the creation of the Cordillera Administrative Region, mandated to democratize and help establish the genuine government of the Cordillera Autonomous Region. By virtue also of this negotiated law, we of the Cordillera People's Liberation Army agreed that we will not anymore play the leading role. We will play the supporting role as mandated in the EO 220. The CBA-CPLA is now satisfied with the present organic act draft in spite of its weaknesses. We see its weaknesses, unlike the first draft, as non-essential, hence merely tactical and non-strategic. In fact, this tactical weakness can even become our strength if we are able to handle it correctly and immediately. And I believe we should and we could, as articulated by Honorable Mayor Dumugan. We fought for no less than a strong regional autonomous government. We sincerely believe that this is the only way we could effectively and efficiently serve our people now. You cannot serve if you are not strong. Let our genuine and selfless love of the development of our people be the source of our strength, the light of our liberty, and the foundation of our commitment to the progress of humanity. Ag Diyos ako na iti agnina.
Right.